Shibava song, Shepherd song,
Savior of a song, Lover of a song.
We are on the Lord's side. We will never give up.
Thank you, bless you, worship you. We exalt you because you are a good God. Christians of this, we thank you for the opportunity you've given us, O God, to come before you this morning. Lord, on us, O God, first it. We us see that another day has come again. We us lift our work of this morning, all by your mercy, all by your grace. Lord, we have come to hear from you as Mary and Martha came before you. While I was busy trying to help you at the wrong time. Right in the wrong time. Lord, help us, O God, to treat on your word this morning. Help us to know that, O God, you value your word more than any other thing. More than present and body, so I speak to you, use me to your glory. Speak to me and speak to me to the end that we all be blessed this morning in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The devil and his co-host have been expelled out of our midst. In Jesus Christ, mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
During this morning, we have a message from the throne of mercy titled, Your Hidden Secrets Are Known to God. Your hidden secrets are known to God. It might not be you. The Lord is talking to us this morning, maybe by somebody on Facebook, maybe somebody on YouTube. I believe you that's on Zoom, you are very holy and pure. You may not, right now, you must have know all this to know what you ought to do. Nevertheless, we are told this morning that the secrets that we are keeping, we thought nobody know, is known to God. The devil also know it too. And as you are happy that your secret is being sealed up, you bury it down, 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 down below your heart. And you are happy my husband don't know about it. Even my pastor, no matter how he pray, cannot know anything about it. And friends don't know anything about it. It has been concealed, buried in my heart. Just as you are rejoicing, so also the devil is rejoicing. The devil is even happier than you. The devil is more happy that that thing is not known to anybody. The devil is more happy that you have not confessed that sin, knowing that a place is waiting for you, where it will be revealed and you will not do anything about it again. The devil is so happy that you have imperfectly concealed that secret and that nobody knows anything about it, but only him and God know. And is patiently waiting for you to come to the point of no return, where it will be revealed and you will not be able to do anything about it. Now that you have life, now that I have life, to willingly pour it out for the whole world to know if that is the way God needs it, for your husband to know about it, for your wife to know about it, you better do it now. Before it gets to a point of no return. Nothing is hidden from the Lord. The Bible told us in the book of Luke chapter 12, 1 to 3. Luke 12, 1 to 3, he said, in the meantime, when they were gathered together, an innumerable multitude of people, and as much that they trod one upon another, he began to say unto his disciples, first of all, beware ye of the leaven of the Pharisees, which is hypocrisy. Meaning, let me say this quickly. If you are having any hidden secret, it's a sin. Every other thing you are not doing before God to him is an hypocrite. You are an hypocrite. So long you are trying to conceal anything, whatever you are not doing openly to God is still hypocrisy. Verse 2 of Luke chapter 12. For there is nothing covered. Get that now. There's nothing covered that shall not be revealed. It might not be revealed here on earth, but it will certainly be revealed someday where it is expected. Neither heat that shall not be known. Maybe, let me quickly say this. Maybe when you were in secondary school, you did something and your friend was beating for it. You were able to conceal it. They were asking your class, who did this thing? You kept your mouth shut. And because of you, they flogged everybody in the class. Remember, we have different spirits. So spirit might just, they might just flog some people and they'll just overlook. Some people they flog, they have vowed never to forgive you. Think about it. Is there anything you have done? Maybe even when you were home, you did the thing. People say, hey, Abiola, who did this? Emmanuel, who? He said, mommy, not me, that's not me. And they beat every of your brothers and sisters, your siblings. Hey, you better take it twice now and do something about it. That shall not be known. Verse 3, therefore, whatsoever ye have spoken in darkness shall be heard in the light. You that, as my brother was saying that day, whenever you and your husband are in the house, all you are doing is to scandalize or standardize people's name. It's hearing it. All you are doing is to bring your fellow sister, fellow brother, and you are stabbing and do whatever you like to the name of that person. Say, I am hearing it. One day, it may not be your earth here again, it will be revealed someday. You put your mouth into what you don't know. You say whatever you like against anybody because nobody is there to challenge you. No problem. You say here now, it shall be revealed. And that which you have spoken in the ear, in closet, shall be proclaimed upon the housetop. The Lord is warning me and you that nothing hidden that shall not be revealed. Just as he told the apostles, anything I tell you in the closet, go and proclaim it. Go and preach it. So also, whatever you and that your friend is saying, whatever you and that whoever your companion in iniquity are doing, and you people are very good in secrecy, don't worry. You will be surprised. As you are fully yourself, then your friend is going to God, Father, please, oh, I am sorry. Everything I said today, I'm sorry. We say this, we say that. You will be surprised that your friend have even gone to that person and confess. But you, that is so foolish, you keep on following her or following him to do things, to say things that you don't know. One day, you'll be expecting that your friend will go to hell with you. On that day, you'll be surprised you're going alone. That's why you must be very, very careful. Every secret of man is open to the spirit, to the spirit God. We are flesh. We are carnal people. Let me just put it that way. But there's a spirit God who pierces into the heart of people. Say the heart of man is deep and desperately wicked. Who can know it? Say, I, God, search the heart and to give to every man according to his work. Or according to his thoughts. He knows your thoughts. He knows your action. He knows everything about you. Nothing is hidden from him. Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 9 and 10. every single man is known to the Spirit God. Luke chapter 8, verse 17. For nothing is secret that shall not be made manifest, neither anything hid that shall not be known and come abroad. It will be exposed. Now you have the opportunity to reveal it to your husband. Look, my husband, this our first son is not our own. It's not your own. It was another man. It's another man's shadow. Say it now. It's better your husband is angry now. Even make him say, okay, I let the marriage scatter. I will not marry again. Go and put it to prayer. The Lord himself will speak to him again. He will reveal your better part to him. I say, my wife, come back. He said to your husband, whatever you know, you have to tell your wife now. Tell your husband, you better say it now. Whatever I know, I have to tell the congregation now. I better say it now. And whatever you also know, you have to tell me now. You better say it now, because a day is coming. All the demons will be there. All the angels will be there. So we fold their hearts, wait for you to come. The angels will be rejoicing. Yes, finally, the man is coming. The one is coming. And if the Lord now opened that secret to you, and it's not made to all of them, all the angels that were rejoicing, after all the evangelism, after all the preaching, she's coming. They'll be sad at the end. At the end, the demons that were sad before, they will rejoice. What do? You better pour it out now, so that on that day, you'll be free to enter the kingdom of God. The Bible told us every creation of God, they are naked before him. No matter where dressed you are, the Lord knows everything about you. He knows the inside, he knows the outside, he knows everything about you and I. So let us not even try to keep secrets from him. Open it. Whatever you have done, let it be known unto God. Whatever you have done to men, let it be known unto them. Because you came into this world, surely we go back. And the Lord expects you and I. When we are coming, there was no secret. We came just as we are. The Lord also wants us to go back to him. If you go back to God, buried evil in your heart. If you go back to God, things that were supposed to be exposed, you carry it there. You will forever regret why you once come or came to this world. Hebrews chapter 4. Verse 13. Say, neither is there any creature, including you and I, that is not manifest in his sight. Everything we are doing, openly and secretly, is being manifest in his sight. I have the opportunity to see some mirror, just like television, partition. Everybody in the world have their own. Everybody, even though we are trillions in the world, you have just a CCTV, you have your own, and it's being watched every second. When the Amaraba comes to steal them, they will go and pray again, it will come and replay. That's how the Lord will replay everything. The day you were concealed in your mother's womb, till the day you breathe the last breath, that's how the Lord will play it out unto you. What about when you start playing it, you start seeing all those things you were supposed to pour out when you were in the world, knowing that after death, judgment. I say it again, Hebrews 4:13. Neither is there any creature that is not manifest inside, but all things are naked and open unto the eyes of him with whom we have to do. Everything we need to do is before him. Let us do everything in holiness and in righteousness. Children of God, stop gossiping. Very, very important. Stop stabbing people at the back. And the only way we can do this, we must stop getting angry unnecessarily, so that we'll not push ourselves into eternal destruction. The Lord help me, I help you in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I think it's healing. from my wife now, and from you people, is being known to God. Is being known to your angel. Your angel is taking inventory of everything you'll be doing right from the beginning. You better, when you get to now, open the page of your past. You know, the Bible says, if anyone be in Christ, is a new creature, all things are passed away. There are things you act by your own self, like restitution, all these things. I also bring to the Lord, and say, Lord, I pour it to you. The one that is supposed to be poured to man, please do it. When I came to your house that time, this is what I did. When I did it, this is what I did. Please do it. So that you will not labor in vain. We shall not labor in vain in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I brought this to us in the book of Psalms, chapter 44, verse 21. Psalms 44:21. Shall not God search this out? Ask yourself this question now. This thing I am keeping now, shall not God search this one out? How long can I keep this one now? This thing I did to my friend, I remember how I take my friend's name to a native daughter. Cannot God search this one out one day now? A friend that loved me so much, I took her name to Celestial Church. I started saying, kill her, frustrate her. Shall not God say this one up now? Before I can remember, before I married, this is my husband, this is my wife, I took his name to native daughter. I gave her name, his name to native daughter, or to my mother, to give native daughter. You better tell your husband now. Before I marry you, this is how I put something in your soup to eat. You better say that even if you confess heaven and earth, or you confess to the man, you will not be forgiven. And one day, the Lord will search it out. And what about if it's being searched out, where you cannot freely confess, or where your husband will not be there again, or your wife will not be there to forgive you? You are doomed. So do it now as you still have hope. I say again, Psalm 44:27. Shall not God search this out? For he knoweth the secret of the heart. He knows how you took that thing all the way from Africa to Europe, or how they posted it to you, that you used to charm that woman, or you used to charm that man. Now the man is thinking it's natural love. You are praying now, oh God, love me. Let the foundation be touched again. The foundation of occur that he ate that time must be destroyed before God's own become. Pour it out. The Lord will save you. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
You know why? If we conceal it, no matter what we do, the Lord will see us from distance. Even if we not use all our heart to believe in, he will never ever fall in love with you. He may still perform miracle in your life, yes, so long you're on earth here. But on that day, he will deny you. The Bible told us in John chapter 2, verse 23 to 25. Now, when he was in Jerusalem at the Passover, in the fifth day, many believed in his name when they saw the miracle which he did. But Jesus did not commit himself unto them, because he knew all men. What did God know about you that will make him not to commit himself to you? Jesus Christ knew that Peter is a man that pour out everything. Peter was an open-minded man. He doesn't. That's why he said, this my son, you are worthy for me to give the key of heaven to. Will God also say, yes, this my daughter, I've searched all your record. You have cleaned all your record. You are worthy of my kingdom, because heaven is clean. Everything you did to people, you did to your uncle when you were staying with him, you did to your parents when you were in the house, the one you can remember, and you also pray, Holy Spirit, please reveal to me all those secrets that was well kept in my head. I so much sealed them up that even me, I forgot it. Holy Spirit, reveal them to me. You know why? If it's not revealed now, it will be revealed on that day. And the Lord say, I don't know you. You don't know me? We all have done. Yes, I don't know you. I only know the secret you kept. And that secret is representing you now. Go back to hell, that secret. In the name of your portion, in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So what do we do? From now on, after we have poured out our heart, let our inner man be the representative of our outer man. Let us be open-minded. Let us stop being secretive. You know why? If you are too secretive, one day you'll be secretive against yourself. I'm not saying you should be foolish. At least to your wife, to your husband, try to be open-minded. So that if you forget to confess it, your husband or your wife will help you. Pour out your heart. Let your heart be open-minded. And again, run from friends who always say, please don't tell anybody. So that their secret will not send you to hell. He's telling you, don't tell anybody. You'll be surprised himself or herself will go and tell the people he said, don't tell. And he has turned you into a grave. He's burying things in you and himself is free from those things. Be careful. Many people are in hell today, not because of what they did, but because of what was buried in them. Tell nobody. Don't tell Apostle. Hey, Apostle, this man, don't tell him. Oh, okay, I hear you. Okay, after the gossiping, let us pray. You are praying. Your friend has turned you into a grave. You are still praying. Grave can never be beautiful. No matter you garnish outside of it, the Lord knows that the person buried there is decaying. God help us in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And that amount of hypocrisy that the Lord hates so much. Matthew chapter 15, verse 7 to 9. Ye hypocrite, where did Isaiah prophesy of you? Saying, if these people draw near unto me with their mouth and honor me with their lips, but their heart is far from me. You love that your friend with your mouth. Oh, Apostle, you are a good man. Oh, my sister, a good man. But the things he confidently told you, the thing he told you, you are using it to scatter him at the back. Hey, I thought my sister was holy. See, oh. Hey, I never knew this sister is like this. Why don't you, when she called you, why don't you pour your heart before him? My sister, this thing you're telling her is not good, though. You mean you are doing this? No, but you conceive it, conceives your heart. You behave as a camel, you show your color with his color. And after then, you brought out your real color and begin to scandalize him. The sin of that person is upon you now. Mm-hmm. The sin that was confessed to you, the sin you know, and you did not do anything about it before the person. And you help the person to seal it up. You are not the one telling people about it. The sin will be upon you. You know why? The person that poured it to you is not your own. So therefore, be very careful the way you handle situation. Let the heart remain to know your friend. If you cannot keep it, tell your friend, I cannot keep it. If you don't love that friend, let the friend, I don't love you. I try to love you, but it's not done. It's not working. Then pretend you love him. Pretend you love her, but you are nearly him. You are nearly her. All you are doing is to make sure that person is there. The Lord is watching you. It's not hidden from him. It's hidden from her. Whatever you are doing to that sister, to that brother, God is watching you. He's talking to me now. Talk to him. And I pray, Lord, help us in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
If you read Isaiah 29, verse 10 to 15, the same thing Isaiah was saying there. Come to God, I see they love him. They move with that friend. I see they're in love. But meanwhile, all they are planning is how to destroy the woman, the man, and the marriage. 1 John chapter 2, verse 9 to 11. See, he that said he is in the light and hated his brother is in darkness even until now. 10. He that loveth his brother abideth in the light, and there is no occasion of stumbling in him. Verse 11. But he that hated his brother is in darkness and walketh in darkness and knoweth not whither he goeth, because that darkness hath blinded his eyes. You love your brother? Love him openly and secretly. If you say you love me, do it openly and secretly. If I say I love you, I must do it openly and secretly. Don't nail me at the back and love me at the front. Don't destroy me at the back and pretend to love me. The Lord is seeing you. The Lord is seeing us. On the last day, it will pour out. And what am I going to do? If what that person think I was to him was not what I was, Percy would be free. I gave my heart. But all you were doing was you were stabbing it. How are you going to face it that day? This life you are living now, I think to you is favorable. You are enjoying it. You have become a tale bearer. You are able to pierce into people to love you. It's to your own detriment. Why don't you bring out your true color? It's better people know you for being realistic than you are being loved for being a chimera. On that day, you regret it. Praise Master Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. I'll stop very soon. Titus chapter 1, 15 to 16. Say, unto the pure, all things are pure. But unto them that are defiled and unbelieving is nothing pure. For evil their mind and conscience is defiled. Though they are singing, though they are preaching, though they are praying, nothing is pure about them. So long any little part of them is defiled. Bible says every other part is defiled. That's why you must let everything be pure. Verse 16. They profess that they know God. Everybody know, hey, everybody, I even listen to them. I want to be like this fervent sister. This sister is so fervent. Oh, this man of God is so hardworking. They profess they know God. We are outward display. But the Bible says, but in works, they deny him. Be abominable and disobedient, and unto every good work, reprobate. That thing you are keeping have disqualified you before God. You profess to know him, so ask for display. But the real one, the secret one God wants to see, you are filled in that. And he's saying, every other work you are doing is nonsense before me. Let us check our secret life. Whenever we have closed, it's not between me and my man of God here. What do we discuss? Do we bring the issue of other ministers? Or bring the issue of members and start, instead of start praying, we start scandalizing them? The Lord is watching us. He's sitting with you. After service, all you can see, our sister, was shouting. She said, hallelujah. And you know that you are sent to go and to tell her. But all you are doing is to use it to be planting hatred in the heart of people. Be careful. Oh, that sister. You see that sister today? See the way she was doing on the mountain? I see she's the only person there. The person that was rejoicing over what the person did before. Because of what I say now, the person will not find it. I never see it this way. Ah, that sister. Go and plant the seed of discord in the heart of that person. instead of you to have called that sister, my sister, the way you are shouting or the way you are doing, it's disturbing. Why don't you? But no! We call the people, plant a seed in the heart of sisters and brothers. Repent now. If Apostle Emmanuel do what is not good to you, why don't you call him? Let's settle it out. Why would you go and call Sister Mercy Red and go and plant seed in heart against me? Let us reframe. If we are practicing holiness, let us do it the way it should be done. So that we will not think we are holy, but at the end, meet ourselves in where we are not supposed to be. Lord, help us all in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
That's why I'll start with this. He said to us in Matthew 7:3-5. Before you start telling anybody, look at stain your eyes. Are you sure you have used microscope to look at your own? Why don't you first of all check yourself before you start telling people you are sinning? That's why you have told us, Emmanuel, put your name there. Before you start searching people's sin, check your own very well. I'm not saying don't preach, but you must be very careful the way you are trying to know people's. Hey, let me know, Sister Bata. Your own that is loaded on you, you are not be able to work on it. But all you are doing, you are becoming class prophet. How does write people's name? Who make noise? Or you are even the noise maker. Since nobody can talk to you, you are the one writing people's name down. Your name cannot be there. Even if you do anything, you cannot write your name down when it comes to flog you. No. All you do is to write other people's on. Because it's saying, Emmanuel. Put your name there. Watch. Not back. Look at yourself very well before you start checking other people's own. And why? On that day, both teachers and the student will stand before the Lord, and the secret of man will be exposed. Be careful. Be watchful. Go back home. Sit there. First of all, put your marriage down. Every secret that needs to be exposed between your husband, your wife, please expose it. Then, go to your friends or go to your in-laws. After your in-laws, move to your friends. After friends, come to the mountain. All the gossiping you have ever gossiped about anybody, call the person. Call the person, my sister, I have been gossiping about you. I'm sorry. From now on, whatever you do, I'll be calling direct. Even if you call the person angry, you have done your own. Then, if I call him, he'll be angry. If you'll be angry, why don't you put his prayer? Becoming a tape bearer, planting seed into people who are on their own. They came to the mountain, they went back home freely, they are rejoicing. But you from Kafachan, California, come president in the UK. Let us repent to for the Lord is watching. Follow your lane. Let nobody come from their lane and pollute you. And you also don't leave your lane and pollute somebody. I know of people on this mountain. All they want to do is to make heaven. They try all they want to do. Such people don't go and pollute them. If you are here, not because of heaven, mind your business. Follow it that way. And at the end of it all, every one of us will reap what we have sowed. You go help me, help you. You have the grace to do what we need to do so that on the last day, we'll not regret ever serving God. It will be better if people in here now saying, after all, I didn't serve him before. the after all the service, after everything, still go to hell. What a shame. After you have preached Christ to the world, and you do not obey his will, oh, woe is you, suffer or in vain. After you have walked for the law, and you do not obey his will, oh, woe is you, suffer or in vain. Lord, help me. Pour out, dig out all the secret I've ever buried. Everything I've ever done against my neighbor. Father, bring it back to my memory. All the scandalizing, all the stabbing I've ever done. Lord, bring it back to my memory. And teach me the way to go about them. Open your mouth and pray.
Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, in the name of Jesus, Heavenly Father, the King of Heaven, Father, Son of God, Father, Son of God, Father, I want us to pray and say, Lord,
that pit I dug in my heart that was meant to be bearing evil secret, bearing sinful secret. That everybody in my family, they know that I'm a secret keeper, and that secret is a deadly one. How I killed somebody, they'll come and tell you, you have to get it buried. Lord, I cover that pit now. Every secret that I have, were there, Father, pour it out and cover it up. My heart is not meant to keep evil secret again. In the name of Jesus Christ, open your mouth and pray.
Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, my Father, and my God, Baba, Father, please, I beg of you, Baba, Father, please, oh God, that I see to God that I've been keeping in my heart, oh God, Baba, Father, Lord, I pray that, oh God, Baba, to me, Baba, Father, please, oh God, to my Baba, I pray that, oh God, Baba, in the mighty name of Jesus, Father, please, my heart is not meant to be, oh God, Baba, anymore. Father, please, with your blood, Baba, everything, Baba, that has been buried in my heart, oh God, Baba. Father, please, I pour them out today, Baba, please come and.
Amen. And I pray from henceforth, our tongue will no more be used for gossiping, and our ears will no more be used to hear gossiping again, in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You are there, you are not born again. You have seen how the Lord is dealing with people who are this. Message is meant for people who are born again now. What about you that is not born again at all? Where will you find yourself? Why don't you surrender now? So that he will start treating you the way he's treating us on this mountain. Because he that God loves, he chastises. And he chastises you into his freedom. Confess your sin before him. And those that are supposed to be coming before men, do so and do your restitution. Come for baptism. Come be buried in the water. Come out a new person, and the Holy Spirit will be upon you to run this race to heaven in Jesus Christ, mighty name.
Amen.
Father, I thank you. I bless you. I worship and exalt your name. Lord, you have spoken to me expressly. I've spoken to my brothers and my sister, oh God. Lord, I ask, oh God, that even after this service, keep on speaking until you get to that secret that is supposed to be revealed. Dig it out and give us the confidence to do what is needful in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Father, I know you are not brought this world to condemn us, oh God, but rather to straighten us, oh God, in the right path. Lord, is there any heart, oh God, that is angry instead to be rejoicing over this world? Forgive them, for they don't know what they are doing.
Amen.
Lord, I ask, oh God, that this world will not be a snare to us on the last day, but let it be, as you have said, let it be a propeller, or propel every one of us into your kingdom. Father, have I spoken wrongly? Have mercy. Have I added or subtracted? Have mercy. Let your mercy stand for every one of us on this mountain, because your aim is to see us in your kingdom, to live and to reign with you. In Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
This morning, I know God Almighty has spoken to you, but I don't think you make life celebrating. Is that
please?
Praise the Lord. This is a mountain of solution and redemption prayer ministry worldwide, aka the Shepherd and the Bishop of Our Souls Ministry Worldwide.